Charles Nelson Rush. Pat Crowley. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Buellafont. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny-O. What's wrong? I'll smash you with my purse.
Aren't you sweet?
You forgot your purse, my dear.
Yes, found it backstage there.
Thank you. I'm the new girl on the block.
Yes, you are. New girl on the block.
Jane, there was a big football player. I forgot who it was, who was carrying a purse, and somebody said, oh, I didn't know you carried a purse. He said, it's a large wallet.
Ah. Angry.
Yes.
Would you like to meet our two players here, Carol Fisher and Sally Murphy? Let's have a great round of applause for these two ladies. You got a lot of money to your credit.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that, Carol?
Absolutely fantastic.
Yes, you got $5,600. You have any idea what you're going to do with all that?
Probably buy my sister's and brother's birth Christmas presents and then go home for Christmas.
Oh, it'll enable you to make a long... Well, you can do more than that. You can go around the world for Christmas if you wanted to.
That's an idea.
Now, we're in the middle of round two, aren't we? We have no score showing here. That means you've got one question. And all you have to do is match one celebrity... And you can start crying again, right? Okay, we'll see how this game turns out in a moment or so. Right now, pay attention to this. Well, there, here we go. Push the button. Reveal the final question of this game. Carol Fisher, match one celebrity, you win another game. Marge said, my husband is really strange. When he takes a shower, he wears a blank. Okay, that's how strange my husband is.
I don't want anyone back east to feel bad about the cold. I have never been so freezing all the years I lived in Connecticut in the snowstorm. A little deeper chatter.
It's cold, you mean in California?
Right here in this very place.
Well, in the studio. Oh, it's nice. And, oh, it's cool and nice.
Cool and nice.
Oh, it's lovely here because the lights are so hot. We have to have it cooler.
Keep blowing on us.
All right, stop that.
CBS air conditioning system.
You still like your answer?
Marge said my husband is really strange. When he takes a shower, he wears a blank.
A bathing suit.
A bathing suit. You know, a little earlier I said one celebrity match will win the game. Now I must hasten to point out, in the event of a tie, we go to a tiebreaker. All right, Gary.
I thought everybody wears a bathing suit in the...
Really? That never crossed my mind. Did it cross your mind?
Oh, yes, it certainly... Also, it crossed my waist.
Right there.
As well. I said a raincoat.
A raincoat is a good answer. Yeah, that's the answer I had in my mind, Carol. What'd you say, Brett?
What do they wear when they surf? Ing. Go surf.
Wetsuits.
Ta-da! Wetsuit.
A wetsuit. Okay, that's
not a match.
That's different from a bathing suit. A wetsuit is different. Charles?
On that... On that way to that glorious tie in the sky, I said raincoat.
All right. Now, Carol, you're looking for a bathing suit, aren't you? What do you offer, Pat?
Well, I put suit, but you could fill in the bathing.
No.
Not shy enough.
This is a suit, my dear. That's not
a
bathing
suit.
It's
a very good looking suit.
Thank you.
Is it a little dark here where Pat's sitting there?
No, I guess not. All right, Richard.
What's the question?
The question is, Marge said my husband is really strange. When he takes a shower, he wears a bathing suit, according to Carol Fisher.
I said he wore a raincoat. Now you say, why?
Why did he wear a raincoat?
Because he was known as a splasher.
A splasher! Did you get that, Joyce?
I got it.
You did get it.
Yeah, I
you
don't
understood
know if
it.
I liked it, but
right.
I got it.
Okay. Show us yours.
What?
Show us yours.
If you're wearing a bathing suit in the shower, what happens to it? It becomes a wetsuit. No.
No. No, it doesn't.
And if you,
but nice try.
Right on the giant, you're a pleasure.
Yes. So, the game ends in a tie. You got a reprieve, Sally. That means we go to a tiebreaker. I push a button with my magic finger. Oh, there we go. We'd have to wipe this clean because the slate is already clean. four questions, and I don't want to say we got two. Well, I don't want to say that there. All right, one question for each of you ladies. The one who will score the most will be the winner. Sally, your choice.
I'll take A.
A. This is a tiebreaker, so that means everyone plays. Hey, I've got good news and bad news.
No kidding.
Yeah. The bad news is Martians have landed in Los Angeles. Yes. Now, the good news is they eat blank. Oh! Oh, dear.
They eat raincoats, right?
There's a lot of choices for that question.
The good news is, the bad news is...
The bad news is...
They landed.
Martians have landed in Los Angeles. The good news is they eat...
Don't give me a clue.
I'm not going to give you a clue.
I want my answer. Yeah.
Just land. They've been walking around on Hollywood Boulevard since
really?
I came out here.
I don't know. I haven't noticed any. Think about it. Not too hard, because you'll strain the...
She's got nothing there to strain, honey. Hi, Joyce.
All right, Charles. There we go. Sally Murphy. I've got good news and bad news for you, Sally. The bad news is Martians have landed in Los Angeles. Now, the good news is they eat...
Smog.
Smog. I think that's very good. Yeah. She's come up with a terrific answer. Every member in this audience loves her answer. Aren't you going to be ashamed of yourselves as you start revealing your answers now? Gary?
If only we could have gotten him to land in Detroit. I said smog.
Smog! Good for you, Sally. Brett?
That is a terrific answer. I wish I'd said it, but you know how I feel about agents.
Yes.
I said they ate agents, and I hope he started with mine.
Brett works out all of her hostilities on this show. Saves her $50 an hour on the couch. Charles?
I'm going to get in trouble for my answer.
Why?
The only thing that frightens me.
What?
Highway patrolman.
Highway patrolman.
With those red lights.
Yeah. Well, we've had two cops on this show, haven't we? We're going to have another one soon. He'll get you, Charles. All right, Pat Crowley. Sally Murphy says, the good news is they eat smog, and it's a marvelous idea.
It's a great, great answer, except that we've had such beautiful clear weather, I completely forgot about the smog, and I wrote people.
People.
I like to eat people.
All right.
Yes. Richard? So, give that little lady some smog, Joyce.
I said that they eat MCs on game shows.
You're a rotten kid. A rotten kid is what you are. Holy mackerel. Okay, now, Sally, that's two for you. When we come back, you'll have to... match two celebrities to stay in the game and achieve a tie. However, you could win if you match three. Come back right after this message, especially for you.
Buzzer is doing our part to make sure Let's Laugh Day is the funniest day of the year. Stay tuned. We now return to Let's Laugh Day on Buzzer.
Hello there. Now, we're in the middle of a tiebreaker. Sally scored two celebrity matches with her question. Carol will have to match two to achieve another tie or three to win. When Dr. Hackam, the plastic surgeon, goes to sleep, he doesn't count sheep, he counts blanks.
Hackam.
Dr. Hackam, the plastic surgeon. When he goes to sleep, he doesn't count sheep, he counts blanks. Finished. Finished. Okay.
Plastic surgeon was
right.
The operative phrase.
Everybody ready now? Put it in the slop there, Joyce.
The worst pun I think I've ever heard.
Joyce, what are you doing there?
I didn't like it.
Well, do it again now.
No, I didn't mean it as a pun. I don't know how to do it.
All right, now she's finished. We come over here. Carol Fisher. When Dr. Hackam, the plastic surgeon, goes to sleep, he doesn't count sheep. He counts blanks.
What?
Noses.
Yeah, noses is good.
Yeah, plastic surgeons do more nose jobs probably than anything else.
I would say that that answer is right on the noses.
Right on the noses there. That's one for you. Score is 2-1 now. Brett?
Count my nose. I'm a stranger in sleepy life.
All right. Got a tie score now. Charles?
I said chin.
Chin. Uh-huh. Ho, ho, ho. So we got a tie score, 2-2. This little lady's looking for a nose.
Oh, and she doesn't have one here. She's got a lot
wrinkles.
Of wrinkles.
Wrinkles.
Yeah. Yeah. Didn't you say you did?
Give that little lady a nose job, Richard.
Pardon?
Give her a little nose job.
You like California?
I love it.
I thought you'd come around.
Now, you stand by for a moment here while we talk to Sally Murphy. Thank you for showing up here and playing our little game with us.
I had a good time.
Good, thank you. A pleasure to meet Sally Murphy. We've got gifts for you. Goodbye, my dear. Yeah. What? You want to hold on? Sure, you can hold on if it'd get a little shaky up here. But, gee, this is your second time up here, Carol. You shouldn't be shaky anymore, are you? You are. All right, I'll hold on to you so you don't shake us both here off the stage. Now, you've matched our celebrities and you've won your second game. Now let's see how good you're going to be in matching a studio audience and guessing what they said in certain circumstances. We polled a recent audience, Carol, and we got their best response to this. Mississippi blank. Now, the answer that that group gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Now, if you match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom one gets you $100. Three of our celebrities are permitted to assist you here.
Gary.
Gary is number one.
Mississippi River.
Mississippi River. All right.
Brett.
Brett, have you got one?
How about Mississippi Mud?
Yeah.
That's a Mississippi Mud, yes. That's two. One more.
Richard?
Mississippi Gambler.
Mississippi Gambler. All right, now you've got Mississippi Gambler, Mississippi Mud, and Mississippi River. Now you can choose one of those if you like, or if you've got a better idea in your head, give us that one.
River?
You want the river. Okay. This little lady is looking for Old Man River. Let's find out if it's flowing along there under the $100 response. Hello, Earl. Earl, are you in there? Are you there? Just, you see, when I say, let's see if it's under the $100 response, then you have to slide the thing, okay?
Did they forget to feed them?
Are you listening, Earl? Okay. Can you hear me loud and clear? All right, knock twice if you understand. Okay, you understand. All right. Now, let's see if the Mississippi River is flowing under the $100 response. Attaboy, Earl! Let's hear it for Earl. Okay, Mississippi Queen. Oh, I knew her well. Now, let's see if the Mississippi River is under the $250 response. Mississippi Mud. You can beat your feet on the Mississippi Mud. That's a marvelous old song. Back my mother used to sing it when I was a child on her knee. Here's the last chance for the Mississippi River with the $500 response. River, congratulations! Well done. You're going great. Carol, your total winnings now are over $6,000. You got $6,200 to be exact about that. More importantly now, you've won the $500. You're going to play for 10 times that amount. But in order to collect that, you've got to match one of our celebrities exactly. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Going to try Richard again, all right?
I gave her Gambler.
Yes, right now. Now, we've got a little problem here, Carol. I have to reach over there and get the question, you see. And you're holding my hand, and you won't let go. Oh, now, all right. All right, just face me exactly here. Okay, you can cross your leg. You can hold on to my elbow if you want to do that. That's allowed there. This one is worth $5,000, and it goes like this. Jump on the blank. Jump on the blank. You think about that? It's a hard one. Yep. All right. Now, boy, he had a little trouble with that one now, but he finally came up with an answer, and now it's up to you, Carol. We want you to give us an answer which you think will match his. And if you do, that'll earn another $5,000 for you and give you a grand total of 11-2. What do you say to that? Jump on the...
bandwagon.
Jump on the bandwagon. Bandwagon is what you said, Richard. What do you say, sir?
I thought that was fall off the bandwagon. All I could think of was jump on the trampoline.
Trampoline.
That's very hard. I couldn't think of
that. Was a difficult one.
Like,
yes.
Jump on the bed or just...
Yeah.
What's jump on the bandwagon?
Jump on the bandwagon is an old phrase, but everybody climbs aboard, you know, and say, well, he's going along with the crowd. He's jumping on the bandwagon.
I thought that was climb on the bandwagon.
Climb on the bandwagon. Yeah.
No, I thought, I think that's...
Is that the way it goes?
Yeah.
Climb on the bandwagon? It's jump on the bandwagon.
Anyway, mine is trampoline.
Trampoline, there.
Doesn't match?
No, it does not match.
It does not match?
No.
Well,
no.
I'm amazed at that, but I'll accept it.
But, you know, Carol, you've still got your $6,200. Nobody's going to take that away from you, and you're going to meet another player later. But right now, this message for one and all.
Celebrates National Let's Laugh Day, starting with more of TV's funniest game show moments, hosted by William Shatner. Then some of our favorite funny episodes. Buzzer celebrates National Let's Laugh Day all night long.
Not twice, if you understand.
Tonight, starting at 11, on Buzzer. Let's laugh.
Hello there.
There's Earl.
Oh, hello there. Hi, Earl. Some of the studio audience want to see what Earl looked like, and that's Earl there. All right. Now, we're ready to play another game. If you are, would you please welcome Mr. Jack Butts here. Hello, Jack.
How are you?
Now, where are you from and all that, Jack?
I'm from the big city of Encino, California.
Encino, California.
You know,
I know it well.
You know it well. I think I've heard that name mentioned before.
Yes, you have.
And you know
we're
what
just
I,
funny. What?
You know what I do there?
What?
I have a little motel in Encino.
Well,
I knew he looked familiar.
We do a lot of funny on this program.
Did I leave any earrings?
Yeah.
No, I'm sure I didn't.
And where is your place in Encino? What street's it on?
I can say that?
There's one main street.
We'll find out.
Yeah. Well, there's one main street in Encino, isn't it?
Ventura Boulevard.
Ventura Boulevard is the main street.
That's
yeah.
Right.
And how long you been there, Jack?
15 years.
15 years, yes. I guess you've seen a lot in 15 years.
Oh, yes, I have. You can believe it.
Yes. All right. Now, from now on, your lips are sealed, right, Jack?
Si. Okay. Si, senor.
Yes.
Si, senor.
All right.
Wasn't it cute the way Mr. Butts pretended he didn't know us?
Yes.
It was terrific. Thank goodness we wore our sunglasses today.
All right, Jack, please make a selection here, A or B.
I'll have to take B.
B it is, for Butts. Okay, everybody was amazed when the Kojak look-alike contest was won by a blank. Very good, Richard.
Thank you.
Terrific answer. Oh, that is a one marvelous answer here. I'm not going to give it to you.
I think I have the
I've got it in my head for ESP. That's what Jack Butts is doing over there now. He's trying to get a little ESP going. All right. Come on now, Joyce.
Huh?
Do something.
Okay.
Everybody was amazed when the Kojak look-alike contest was won by a... Right. Now, Jack Butts, go. Everybody was amazed when the Kojak look-alike contest was won by a...
I even forgot who Kojak is.
Kojak. Kojak is a bald-headed fellow who plays a detective.
A billiard ball.
What's that?
A billiard ball.
Well, that's what he looks like.
Yes.
You say the car. That's
all I can come up with.
Well, he has promised not to try to get into show business. He's going to stay in the motel business. Gary?
That crossed my mind, but I said a hard-boiled egg.
A hard-boiled egg. Oh, that's as bad as a billiard ball. Brett?
Now, isn't this almost a match?
What?
A bowling ball.
Bowling ball is not a billiard ball, but you had the same idea as he had. Charles.
A bowling ball.
Bowling ball. Well, nobody's come to my answer yet. Pat Crowley, let me see your card there.
I have a blonde-haired lady.
A lady, yes. She would be a bald-headed lady, wouldn't she? Richard?
El Womone.
A Womone, no. Bella, signora, what do you say?
A lady.
A lady, right. Everybody's amazed when the Kojak look-alike contest was won by a lady, you see, because Kojak is a man. Do you understand, Majak? Okay. Now, yours will come along later, but right now this is going to come your way. Pay attention, friends. Goodbye. Say goodbye, Carol.
Goodbye.
See you next time.
Goodbye, Gene.
See you later, Jack.
see you tonight at the old hotel.
We'll see you next time. Okay. You're all splendid. Yeah.
Mrs. Miller.
All right. Don't wake her up there. Yeah. I will say goodbye. Gene Mabry here. Join us next time for Match Game 75.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Are you ready?
My first day here, you know.
Your first day here,
yes,
in a long time.
Not in the thing yet.
Yeah, you're getting the swing of it.
You'd have to be an idiot dumbbell to miss that one. I can
potato chips.
Okay.
I said potato chips.
Thank God.
Okay.
And this makes it four.
Four? All right, Richard.
Well, Bill was right. You've got to be an idiot dumbbell to miss this. I said cow chip.
Cow chip.
Match game. I love match game.
Match game was the most silly fun.
Red, white, and blue is the color she is wearing today.
Right down to him.
Sorry. Got me into show business.
Make sure you tell the people that I'm not really with these others.
Charles, I suppose I shouldn't say this. Should I say this?
Roses are red, violets are blue. Brett and Charles is too.
But he's outrageous.
Hey, how yellow, how a ho ha.
He is absolutely outrageous.
Charles, what are you doing? Brett happened to sit up in the middle in a top tier, and Charles Nelson Reilly was on her left, and they liked each other, and they complimented one another, and it was a natural combination. Come on. Come on now. Let me see it. Water bag. Water bag.
The most fun I could think I had.
We depend on you because you're like Old Faithful.
Good. I'll erupt for you on the hour.
Okay.
Well, it went on and on and on.
I'm the first one finished.
You're the best.
You were finished a long time ago, sweetheart.
There.
That's the first time a man's gotten a kick out of bread in years.
Match game with Gene was not a job, it was a social engagement.
Match wits with your favorite Match Game stars every day on Game Show Network.
I know